Hi, it's Kiffin Labates here, and today I'm looking at slide 4 of Tommaso Di Bartolo's slide set on NFTs and areas in which they may be of interest. And slide 4 concerns fractional NFTs. So that is something that in technical terms is actually fairly trivial. If you have an NFT, then you have a smart contract with a data structure in it called a mapping that has token IDs matched to their owners, or rather their owners' addresses, except that a mapping only allows for one address. Actually, that's not entirely true. You could put an array of addresses as the owner of a particular token, as identified by its token ID, but let's not get too complicated here. A traditional ERC 721 or an ERC 1155 token contract that's being used as an NFT contract will have a list of token IDs and a matching list of token owners. And in the standard, you can only have one owner per token. However, you can get around this by wrapping individual NFTs. And what that is a rather confusing term that means you get the NFT to be owned by a contract. So now the token ID has a corresponding address that is a contract address rather than what is known as an externally owned account or a personal address. And then you can use the contract to fractionalize the NFT. You can have a smart contract that owns the NFT, and then you can have multiple addresses that have some kind of control over that contract. And in that manner, you can have more than one address influencing the ownership of the NFT. I don't know if this is sounding really clear yet, so maybe an analogy is in order here. It's like a house being owned by multiple people. So if me and my wife buy a house, we get both our names put on the deed, and then I can't just go off and sell it without her permission and vice versa. That would be one way of fractionalizing the ownership of a house. And you can do the same thing with an NFT. You can say this NFT is now owned by a contract, and that contract is controlled by two people, and they both have to sign off if the NFT is to be sold. So that's a simple, trivial way of fractionalizing an NFT so it's owned by two people. And of course, it can be more than two people. You could have, say, 100 people who each have an address stored in the wrapping contract, and all of them have to sign off before the NFT can be sold, or maybe a proportion of them, say 80% of them, have to sign off. And you can even have weightings. You could say that an NFT is owned by three people, and either person one and person two have to sign off on it, or person three can sign off all on their own. In that case, the third person would have the kind of deciding vote on whether an NFT is to be sold on or not. So, as I said, from a technical point of view, this is fairly trivial stuff. It's not really that interesting. But from a business sense, well, then it is useful, because we have plenty of cases in the real world where people own fractions of something. For example, companies. You have a company and it has a company ID and it's a single entity, but you have multiple owners, and their ownership is shown through their ownership of shares in the company. And it's owning those shares that gives them the right to vote at the annual general meeting of the company, and that allows the shareholders to, for example, fire the board or put pressure on the board to fire the CEO or things like that. In practice, in the business world, it's rather hard for shareholders to have much influence over a company. It really is kind of like an emergency brake. It takes something pretty significant for the shareholders to revolt against a board. Anyway, I've kind of wandered over the terrain here, but that's slide 2, fractional ownership of NFTs. Not got amazing scope, I think, but maybe there are some use cases out there that I haven't really thought of. Anyway, slide 4 covered. Look out for another video soon, in which I'll be looking at slide 5, and I can't remember off the top of my head what the topic of that one is. See you in the next video soon. Bye for now.